Governments have implemented various social assistance programs to alleviate poverty. But they have a very difficult question to answer. Which programs are most effective? Furthermore, how do they ensure that funds intended for social assistance programs are not lost to corruption or leakage, or that they're reaching the right people? Governments have access to rich administrative data that can help answer these questions. By working together with researchers to utilize de-identified versions of this data, rigorous evaluation of social programs can be possible. In 2002, Indonesia launched a national rice subsidy program known as Raskin, or Rice for the Poor. Researchers working with the government found that beneficiaries received only one-third of the intended subsidy. The government thought that providing participants with identification cards printed with information about their entitled benefits could empower households to request their full benefits. But how did they know who to send these ID cards to? The government looked to its administrative data, in this case, the Unified Database, or the UDB. What is the UDB? It is an electronic database that contains social, economic, and demographic information on roughly 24.5 million households, or over 96 million individuals with the lowest welfare status in Indonesia. The UDB is used to target households that are eligible to receive social assistance. The data collection method for the UDB must be chosen carefully so that no household is incorrectly excluded from a program they might need. This is not an easy endeavor. However, researchers helped inform the updating of the UDB by testing different data collection methods. As Indonesia's long commitment to improve social program continues, other questions arise. In 2017, policymakers were asking what could be the impact of changing Raskin, at the time called Rastra, from physical rice delivery to an electronic voucher. Researchers worked with the government to add questions about social assistance in Susenas, an existing biannual national sample survey, to help them analyze long-term impacts of the program without any additional costly data collection. This collaboration made it possible to evaluate one of the biggest social program reforms in Indonesia. JPAL's Innovation in Data and Experiments for Action Initiative, or IDEA, aims to enhance the use of administrative data for evidence-informed decision-making. To learn more about IDEA and how to get involved, visit www.povertyactionlab.org/IDEA.